4:22 a.m. Eastern Standard Time 0422, stumps England 13:24 trail by 127 runs updated at 4:27 a.m. Eastern Standard Time Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus 4:19 a.m. Eastern Standard Time 0419 cricket.com.au at Cricket House update play has been abandoned on day 4. Play to begin at 10 a.m. local time tomorrow. Gold coin donation to at Movember House for entry Ashes December the 17th, 2017 Facebook Twitter Google Plus 4:14 a.m. Eastern Standard Time 0414 Facebook Twitter Google Plus 4:09 a.m. Eastern Standard Time 0409 How do Australia manage to get permanently injured players to peak during Australian Ashes, says Ian Forth. To wit, Harris, Cummins. And why are England always in transition? With the exception of 2010, they remind me of Darren Anderton, the old Spurs player, who always seemed to be just good enough to get in the team for major tournaments, then disappear to the treatment table between times. Of course, nothing beats 2002 when England managed to arrive with three of their best players, Flintoff, Gough, Thorpe, all unavailable, and then lost their surprise fast bowler Jones on the first morning of the series. Do you know, that's a great point, Bruce Reid in 199,091 is another example. And it's not injury-prone bowlers who peak at the right time. Stuart Clarke played his only five at his series in 200,607 and top ahead of wickets. Facebook Twitter Google Plus 3:51 a.m. Eastern Standard Time 0351 Facebook Twitter Google Plus 3:48 a.m. Eastern Standard Time 0348 Rainbreak Chit Chat But Rob, when has Cook last been really in form, says Andrew Hurley. And if he is only badly out of form and not gone, what in God's name is he doing in an Ashes series? It's crazy. He played the best England innings of last summer, 88 against South Africa, without which they might have lost the series to South Africa. He was badly out of form halfway through the 2011 series against India, and he scored 294 in the next game. It's always been the way with Cook. Personally, I think he deserves more respect and more faith. He might be gone, he might not. I trust his judgment on this. Approximately 99.94% of social media foghorns said he was pathetic and should quit as captain in 2014, but he got that right. I would let him play until the end of the series and go from there. This might be his Gooch 199,495 Ashes, a sad end to a great career, or it might be his Atherton 199,899 Ashes. After that series, it was assumed Athers would never play for England again. He played 27 more tests, and some of his finest innings. Facebook Twitter Google Plus 3:41 a.m. Eastern Standard Time 0341 37th over England 12:64 Mallon 28 Bairstow 8 Mallon gets his bat down on a bit of a grubber from Cummins. Yes, well played, says Jeff Boycott, whose hitherto unrequited bromance with Mallon has been one of the features of this test. Whilst the cricket itself is pretty demoralising for an Englishman, begins James Clarke, it is as nothing to discovering that Ricky Ponting is an engaging, interesting, likeable and talented pundit. Honestly, we have no luck at all. Do we wait till you hear Matthew Hayden? Apparently he's a delight. Facebook Twitter Google Plus 3:35 a.m. Eastern Standard Time 0335 36th over England 12:64 Mallon 28 Bairstow 8 Another lovely shot from Bairstow, who gets up on his toes to punch Stark to the extra cover boundary. He looks a level above all the other England batsmen. In fact, he might be the only England player who would get in a composite 11 based on performances in this series. I'm feeling a little disheartened by the state of the game, says Stephen Todd. I feel these teams have been pretty well the same over the last three Ashes, including this one, and none of those series have been especially close. Are local conditions so influential that away teams have no chance? If so, what needs to restore balance? Maybe get rid of the toss and let the visitors choose. I don't like gimmicks like that, but I agree it's a big problem for Test cricket, never mind the Ashes. More warm-up matches might help a bit, though it's hard to fit them in. It doesn't really make any sense because you would think, with globalization, that players would be more comfortable in overseas conditions. Updated at 3:37 a.m. Eastern Standard Time Facebook Twitter Google Plus 3:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time 0330 Updated at 3:31 a.m. Eastern Standard Time Facebook Twitter Google Plus 3:26 a.m. Eastern Standard Time 0326 Facebook Twitter Google Plus 3:19 a.m. Eastern Standard Time 0319 Updated at 3:22 a.m. Eastern Standard Time Facebook Twitter Google Plus 3:13 a.m. Eastern Standard Time 0313 Facebook Twitter Google Plus 3 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 0310 Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, 3:05 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 0305 Wicket, England 1004 Vince B. Stark 55, updated at 3:32 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, 3:01 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 0301 updated at 3:40 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, 2:58 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 0258 Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, 2:52 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 0252 26th over England 873 Vince 45 Mallon 7 Mitchell Stark replaces Cummins, who bowled a virile spell of 61,150. There's a soupçon of movement into Mallon, who gets away with a couple of thick inside edges. Sorry to open this wound, but it seems to me we can chat as much as we like about the makeup of this team, but in the end so many of the problems, Mo, the lack of firepower, the flatness in the field, the pressure on the new batsman, can be traced back to that night in Bristol, says Pete Salmon. Whatever the legal outcome, I think Ben Stokes might find a pretty chilly welcome if and when he walks back into the dressing room. And perhaps the rest of the team should really, really think about whether they need to keep going out and getting pissed. I'm confident they'd have lost 50 with Stokes, though I agree that it has done even more damage than we realized at the time. I can see both sides of the booze argument. Personally, I think they should be allowed out occasionally. Disingenuous reporting doesn't help. It's a difficult thing for the team to get right. Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, 2:39 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 0239 23rd over England 7:63 Vince 36, Mallon 5. This should be a good contest between Lyon and Mallon, who is using his feet at every opportunity. He comes down the track three times in that over, albeit without scoring any runs. The third of those meanders brings a check upstairs for a caught and bowled, with replays confirming that Mallon hit it into the ground. Look, dear England fan, this isn't good, but we'll always have these. Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, 2:35 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 0235 22nd over England 7:63 Vince 36, Mallon 5 Vince, so fluent before tea, is looking a bit edgy now. He gets a leading edge back towards Cummins, all along the floor, and then plays around a delivery that hits a crack and flies for four leg bees. A fine over continues with the bouncer-yorker combo, both well played by Vince. Top stuff from Cummins. Out of the ashes, this series just might be the making of Stoneman, Vince, Mallon and Overton, says Ian Forth. Test cricket's hardly going to get much harder, after all. Yes, mind you, we thought that of the miserable tour of India and Sri Lanka 199,293. With the individual breakthroughs of Chris Lewis dropped two tests later, Graham Hick dropped two tests later and Neil Fairbrother never played again. Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, 2:28 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 0228 Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, 2:25 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 0225 Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, 2:21 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 0221 Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, 2:06 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 0206 T Rain stops play updated at 2:13 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, 1:57 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 0157 17th over England 7:03 Vince 35, Mallon 4 Vince caresses Lyon through extra cover for another high-class boundary. Ah, why can't they all be like James Vince? Rob, I'm disappointed the Aussies declared at 662 and denied Tim Payne his 50, but I'm more annoyed they didn't hang to declare at 666, so the cinema theme could continue by talking about the omen, says Declan Neal. Incidentally, in the original 1976 film We Won't Talk About the Insipid 2006 remake, the character famously decapitated by flying sheet glass was played by the great English actor, David Warner, no relation, I assume. Now that I think about it, Warner's on-screen death was like TV coverage of a batsman losing his wicket, a fatal delivery, depicted in slow motion, from multiple angles. Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, 1:54 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 0154 Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, 1:50 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 0150 Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, 1:47 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 0147 Wicket, England 603 Ruchi Smith B. Lyon 14 updated at 1:50 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, 1:46 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 0146 14th over England 602 Vince 29, Route 14 Cummins replaces the excellent Hazelwood 62,162, and Vince plays a quite gorgeous back foot drive through the covers for four. He is playing so well, and he gets four more with this off-handed edge along the floor. England have hit 12 boundaries in the innings already. Been watching through the night and on my way to Heathrow for a work trip to New York and discussing cricket with a taxi driver, says John Butler. He's from Pakistan and his feeling on the Ashes is that most teams win at home and lose away, simple as that. There's data to back it up. Absolutely. England would beat Australia in England, though it would NT be 50. It's becoming a problem for Test cricket. The next 12 months, when India play in South Africa, England and Australia, will be fascinating. It makes you realise just how good Graham Smith's South Africa were, because they had a fantastic away record. Facebook, Twitter, Google+.